Good morning. My name is Dimitris Amios. I'm a physical therapist. And I'm here to present you classical physical therapy modalities for the treatment of shoulder. First of all, I would like to discuss some common pathologies that we encounter in our clinic. Most of the times we see tendon pathology, rotator cuff tendinopathy, some partial tendon tear. Some other times we encounter subacromial bursitis, which is painful, and we need to address to this issue. In older patients, we see arthritis of the glenohumeral joint or some fractures from falls. And less often, we encounter with patients with adhesive capsulitis. The clinical symptoms that we most commonly address is shoulder pain in the deltoid area or in the lateral humeral area, and sometimes we see patients with reduced range of motion, or many patients, as we saw here, have altered kinematic patterns. Muscle atrophy in some muscles, especially in the rotator cuff, and most of the times, most of the patients have disability and dysfunction. The classification of the physical therapy modalities, according to Tim Watson, is three major groups: electrical modalities, interferential tens, iodophoresis, high voltage, what we most commonly use. The second group is thermal modalities, diathermy, laser therapy, ultrasound, and cryotherapy in some cases. And the third group is non-thermal, which is, from here we'll discuss about the laser. And I didn't find any, for this I don't use this. Okay. In electrotherapy, the most common waveforms that we use is TENS, interferential, high voltage, and iodophoresis with some medication. First, for the TENS, we use it for pain management mainly. The theory that the neurophysiology that explains the mechanism is according to the gate control theory. You all know that. And this is the waveforms that the apparatus is produced. Here is an RCT on patients that underwent arthroscopic rotator cuff repair, and totally 37 patients were measured, and they were divided into two groups: the placebo group and the TENS group. They found that in the visual analog scale, it was a reduction of opioid use by more than 25%, both 2 days after and 1 week after the surgery. Another column that we sometimes use is a differential, which has a deeper effect to two channels. And here it's where we have the main effect. And according to this study, which was performed in people with hemiplegic shoulder pain, they found that after the application of interferential current, there was an increase in the pain-free passive range of motion of these patients. For thermotherapy, there is a study, according to this systematic review, there is evidence that when in patients with rotator cuff pathology, when they, let me remember this. Okay, when they applied local microwave diathermy, they had a similar improvement in pain and function compared to to injections with subacromial corticosteroid medication. For cryotherapy, according to this systematic review, two studies showed that there was improvement in patient outcomes with cryotherapy versus no cryotherapy, and two other studies showed that although there was not a decrease in joint space temperature at 90 minutes after the surgery, 4 and 23 hours after the surgery, there was an increase in a decrease in the temperature. Okay. Next is the low level the laser therapy. This systematic review shows that provides moderate evidence that laser therapy can improve function and reduce pain in patients with impingement syndrome, rotator cuff associated disorders, adhesive capsulitis, and non-specific shoulder pain. Besides that, I would like to discuss some other more important physical therapy interventions, which we do in combination with the modalities, which is therapeutic exercise, manual therapy techniques, and modern modalities as TECAR, laser, and so on. And I would like to present you my dissertation on the medicine school, on the physiology laboratory, which was a pilot RCT on painful shoulders in patients. Totally 25 patients were measured. We performed 12 sessions in every patient. The protocol was 2 sessions per week and 1 session for 4 weeks and 1 session the next 4 weeks. All the patients answered these 2 questionnaires, the Oxford Shoulder Score and the Shoulder Pain and Disability Index. And we performed some measurements of flexion, abduction, internal and external rotation, both active and passive. And these 2 were done in the first, in the 8th, and in the last session. Okay, the first group was the control group, where a protocol of 8 therapeutic exercises was conducted. External rotation. Okay. The second group was the same therapeutic exercises plus 3 manual therapy techniques, which was inferior glide, posterolateral glide, and mobilization with movement in abduction. Patient performed the abduction. And the last group was the same exercises with TECAR application, 15 minutes, 10 minutes of capacitative and 5 of resistive around the shoulder area, deltoid, here in this area, and the supraspinatus area. The result, there was a significant, there's a significant improvement both in pain and disability based on the questionnaires in all the patients in the three groups, and a significant increase in active and passive range of motion in all movements, except flexion, which was not decreased in the first place. The best improvement was found in the 8th session, and after that there was a plateau in the effect, no more improvement, or slight one, not statistically important. There was not any difference between the 3 groups, although we saw that with manual therapy there was a greater improvement in movement. It was not statistically important, the difference. And the same with disability and pain was reduced a lot. And to conclude the whole presentation, there's moderate evidence that pain reduction and improvement in function can be achieved with low-level therapy, electrotherapy modalities such as TENS and differential, and thermotherapy. There is lack of evidence that one type of modality is more effective than another, and there is implication for research in high quality RCTs, which can combine these classical modalities with modern physical therapy interventions. Okay.
Therapy, yeah? Okay. Thank you, Mr.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Samios.